Doezsha Geeks, Doezsha.B's Productions.
What up, YouTube? It's your boy Doezsha.B from Doezsha.B Exotics. I did want to do a quick update, so I hooked up my thermostat. Oh, my incubator. Let's focus. So my thermostat, I'm running it at 95 degrees. But at 95 degrees on the inside, that puts me at 88. 29% humidity. That's just standard. Or without anything in it, so, and let me open it. So I have two computer fans hooked up that all come on with the thermostat. And the way I did it was, I just use I have Zoom Ed heat pad there. I have another one there, and then another one on that wall there. It's all controlled by the thermostat and the fan. Cuts on at the same time, and that's what I had on hand, so that's what I used, and it seems to be working pretty well. I might hear it cut on from time to time. What I am going to do is I'm going to go back in there and put some padding under, like maybe some soft foam under the fans, or maybe around this metal rack here to help reduce the sound of the rattling, but it's not too loud. You hear a little bit. Oh, it just cut off. We're at 10, we're at 88. That's why I have it set too. So, but other than that, we're good. I want to share that with you guys. I'm going to do some testing. Hopefully, my girl over here, down here, is gravid. She looks to be gravid. So, hopefully, that's true. And then, hopefully, get some eggs from her pretty soon. Alright, guys, I will catch you later. Doezsha.B from Doezsha.B. What up, YouTube? So, as I said before, I got the incubator set up. It's holding firmly at 88 degrees there. Thermostat set to 95 degrees. What I do need to get is a proportional thermostat so that it can raise and lower gradually instead of just turning on and off. I got a big bag of the perlite downstairs. In my garage, I got like, it's like, I think it's 2 cubic feet or whatever. And this was clean. I just poured some of this in here and realized that I needed this to use over here for my, this is my egg crate, or my light diffuser, to use for a template. So now I'm going to cut like 10 rolls. So I think this is 9 rolls, basically the footprint of it. I'm gonna cut one more roll down so when I insert it, it will be tight fitting and above the substrate. I also have some corrugated plastic that I got from Home Depot as well. Corrugated plastic board looks just like cardboard but made out of PVC. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna cut strips out of this. Well, maybe cut this in half and then zip tie it against here. So maybe less than half, maybe cut 3 strips out of it. Maybe 6 to 8 inches wide, whatever, to provide shade here and or on this side, to where the back part of the tub that's next to the heat will be dark and make the snakes feel safer. So that's my thoughts on that, and I'm gonna get started and I will check back in a little bit. All right, what up, YouTube? It's your boy Doezsha.B from Doezsha.B Exotics. Right now, just cut this sheet of corrugated plastic into 3 8-inch strips. And it originally was 24 by 36 inches. And what I'm gonna do with these 8-inch strips is I'm gonna end up having to notch them. But right back here next to my window where my rack is, I'm gonna have it to where it's notched to go around the heat element and sit flushly. Pretty much like so, but to provide a shade area back there, kind of replicating having a hide inside of the tub, or in theory that's what I'm aiming for, to see if it helps. But I think it'll help with keeping some of the sunlight out and helping them feel more secure. Still, if anybody out there knows how to get a blind similar to that or something like that, to where some type of like a window covering that I can still let light through, but there's actually metal window coverings on the outside of here, it's like you can see like the screen, but to help keep the heat out. But yeah, something like that so I can let the light through but not have it so bright for these guys here. If you guys have any ideas, let me know, and I'll check back with you and let you see the product after I get finished. Oh, I forgot to mention that I finally found the boxes that I originally set the incubator up with that fit in here, but we're at like 94%. You can see that 94% humidity, and we're at 88 degrees inside of the box. I don't know if it's showing up at all, but it seems like we're holding temps. I have to find once. I'm gonna go clean out some more boxes, go through some more boxes, and put another one of those thermometer hydrometers in this box here at the bottom. That way I can get the temps of that box and see where we're at in both boxes. But I have a larger incubator I created. It's still in the garage right now. It's not finished. This one is finished. And the only thing I'm hopefully I'll get two clutches, but right now I only think one of my girls is grab it. So I just wanted to get it set up and make sure everything was good, and it's just working pretty good. I have no complaints. Alright, what up YouTube, it's your boy Doezsha.B Exotics. So my girl, she's gone right now, and I want to use hole punches to make the holes that I was gonna put the zip ties through to mount it to my rack, these corrugated PVC. So while she's gone, I figure I just purchased the reptile scan app the other day, not too long ago. And it's not gonna focus. I'm just going through the process of logging, just basically getting all my feeding cards. I'm going tier for tier. And just get my feeding cards, and then I'm entering the data on the program. In that way, once I ordered some of these little plastic sleeves, I got myself a photo printer and some photo printing paper, and I ordered some plastic sleeves and a light box from Amazon. So once those items get here, I'll be able to take pictures of my snakes, and then my photo editing software, put them in there and add the QR codes from here. I just have to go to Michael's or something and get some like a roll of maybe like a yard or so of Velcro to put on the back of the little plastic sleeves and the back of the and onto my tub, so I can put all their cards with their QR codes and their pictures on it. But yeah, this is the first process. I was also watching some Triple B TV up here, paused it so the audio wouldn't get picked up, but yeah, this is what I do in my spare time. Alright guys, catch you in a little bit. What up YouTube, it's your boy Doezsha.B from Doezsha.B Exotics, and I just wanted to touch bases and check back in with you and show you the finished product of what I was doing earlier. So I did locate a hole punch. You can say it didn't work, so I just ended up using my drill, and not sure what size bit I used. I have a whole drill index over there, but I got a decently sized bit. Drill some holes, they weren't too big, they're just a little bit wider than the actual zip tie. You can see there, it only zip tied it in the corner, so there's only four. I've drilled two holes here at the top corner, but I end up attaching it here a little bit further down. So where I'm at is I got two at the bottom, two in the middle that are securing both pieces together, and then two almost all the way at the top. But what that does is it provides a little bit of shade and kind of creates a darker area on that end of the tub to give a sense of being in a cave or in an overhang or some type of hide, some type of natural shelter. in these tubs that I don't have hides in for my bigger females, or which is the one I like. I have some empty, it's storage right now. Got some snakes over here, even have some dubia roaches that I'm gut loading. I just brought a starter colony from a local pet shop, so I got those downstairs in my garage, getting them started. So breeding those for my daughter's bearded dragons, and for got one tarantula there, and some spiderlings. But my spiderlings, they eat they all are eating on mealworms right now. Yeah, I breed my own mealworms too, so that's what they're eating on. And I did finish entering all the data from my reptile scan, so I got all of my animals in there now, logged, and now I have to do is add the pictures and start generating the QR codes, and then we'll get the cards all printed up. So eventually I want all my tubs to have the ID tags on them with the QR codes and all of that good stuff to, you know, give it a more professional feel. And that way I'm still going to do the physical paper where I keep track of everything, like my feeding cards here or whatever, whatnot. On top of all my tubs I have feeding cards with the dates and all that stuff. And then some of them that I have weighed have the weights on them, like this one here, 80 grams in a corner there, and just little stuff like that. But I'm gonna keep a physical copy, and I want to have a digital copy where I can just come through with my smartphone and scan it, fed and shed and whatnot. But yeah, I'll catch you guys later. What up YouTube, it's your boy Doezsha.B from Doezsha.B Productions. Today I'm gonna be adding another mod. So I added this one mod right here, which is the corrugated plastic, to actually provide a little bit of a darker area behind the, near the back of the tubs. As you can see, if you can't see, most of the snakes are actually utilizing the darker side, but she's actually over here. My gold blush Mojave girl is chilling over there. But what I did today was I went to Walmart, got some of this foam display board, and then it's two sheets, which was actually like $10 roughly, $10. When I went to Home Depot and bought the one sheet of this, I still have an extra piece of it. This stuff here, the corrugated plastic PVC board, that was like almost $9 for that one sheet. I went back to Home Depot today to see if they had some more, and they didn't. So I went a couple stores over to Walmart and got these two foam boards. So the idea with this is, in conjunction with these little 3M hooks here that you use to like hang pictures or whatever, have little sticky tabs. What I'm gonna do is actually use the hooks just like that, or like this orientation here, or this orientation here, on the back of the foam board facing inward this way. I'm orientate the board to where once I'll get the board in position, then I'll apply the sticky part of the hooks to the foam board so I can just put it up against here, and it should be able to grab and hook, holding the foam board up to this and providing like a blackout, shading the whole rack. And then when I want to take it down, I should be able to lift up and take it down and do my maintenance, feeding, watering, and stuff like that. But I feel that since it's right next to a window, two things. The foam will help keep the heat out, and it'll provide darkness, which we all know ball pythons like darkness. Is that a word, darkness? Well, they like it when it's dark. So yeah, just trying to hook them up and make them happy and comfortable. That way, the gang, the squadron, will be happy. All right, guys, I'll catch you in a little bit with the next part of the next phase of the project. All right, peace. Okay, guys, so upon me opening, unwrapping this foam board, it's not two sheets, but it's one sheet that scored to open up to be one big sheet, which is cool. Like if I have a project in another, for another use, if I had like a project I want to draw like a nice mural or a piece, I have a background in art, and that'd be cool to have a bigger surface. But what I'm going to do, since it's already pre-scored, is pretty much add the strips like this one here. I'm going to take this piece off here, cut that, cut this piece off here, and I will save this centerpiece for future use on another project later. Don't know what yet, but then I'll just use the little hooks to hang it, hang these little pieces to come out to about this far here and provide shade roughly for half of the enclosure. So I'll get with you guys in a moment and show you the next stage of the process. Oh, real quick, the tools that I'm going to use are so standard box cutter, and then we have the adhesive part, and these hooks, already got four of them broken apart. There's six in a pack, so I bought two packs, that way I could put four on each board that I hang. Alright guys, I'll show you the next part of the process momentarily. Okay guys, so the next step what I did was after I cut the piece, now I'm pretty much holding it up where I want it, aligned it. So if you can see here, I took a pencil, marked where that shelf is, and then I came down here, get another pencil mark where that shelf is, and then now I'm going to go back over to my work surface, use my speed square, this guy here, I've got clear space, make my line continuous across on both of my pencil marks, then that's where I'm going to orientate my hooks facing downwards. So I'm going to do that right now. Alright. So now I've got my lines drawn. I guess I could have set my tripod up before I did the lines and drew the line. Rephrase that. And I think I have instructions. Let's see how this goes. So it says to, I'm supposed to peel this off here. There. That's how it goes. You're doing it backwards. Yeah, that feels good. That's on there. Pretty well. And if I did it wrong, so be it. This is how it's going to be. I'll make another one later and I will correct it. But it's just to get the basic process down. I think I'm supposed to do it this way. But I'll do it all the same. Basic process down. See how it's going to work out. Doesn't have to be perfect, just an idea. But I'm messing around and see if I can improve on things and make things better. I just wanted something that can provide more shade and make it darker for my girls that I have on Iraq. I have my male over there. Definitely I'm going to. To make things better for them. But I'm gonna do this for two more times down here. That way I should be able to pop this in place and should be able to hang on this arm. Alright. So I'm gonna catch you back in a moment. Peace. Okay, so I got them all four on there. Now I'm gonna test fit So I'm gonna stop it real, actually I could just, I'm gonna, let me see, let me loosen this up here. What am I doing, Okay. I'm gonna move you guys over while I test fit it. Switch the camera angle. Move the camera first. Just to catch it. Basically, got everything glued together, I mean, everything on there. So in theory, I should be able to just and push down, and voila, there you go. It's on there. It's not perfect. That's gonna drive you crazy with my OCD, but it's better than it was. So I'm gonna repeat the process for the other, this other panel right here. Just gonna mark it here, get into there, draw my line, apply the little adhesive things and the hooks, and then probably take this one off, put the bottom one on first, and then be able to put the top one on since they go up and they start up and go down to hook on. And then when I want to do my maintenance, I just come, push up it, boom, voila, there you go. So I just thought that up, thought of something quick and easy to do to provide more shade and shelter. Actually, what I can do, I'll just leave this one here because I spaced it for that one. So, yeah. But I like it so far. I mean, looks pretty good. I think you guys were uneven. Is that better? Sorry if you guys, if your head was sideways. All right, guys. I guess I'll film the process of the next one. Actually, that's pretty much it. Make it short. I don't want to go dragging out too long. But I'll show you the finished product when I'm done. All right, peace. Good up, YouTube. So now I'm finished with the second one. I haven't tried it yet, so I'm going to try it together. So let's see if I might be able to get to the one without taking the top one off, but. On there, and you know what? I love these little things already. These little hooks, dude, those little things are awesome. They were so easy to use, so boom. And then there was. But we had to give them a little bit more of a sense of security. That nice and level, nice and flush. A little, and I could add more zip ties to the permanent one. Zip ties over here, suck that in one time. But yeah, and that's the finished. This is the finished product. So I got the PX or the PVC, corrugated PVC in the back, which is cool because it will allow a little bit of the heat to go out from my heating element. I don't think it's flammable. Shouldn't be. Then here, it's a bunch of storage. I got a bunch of things going on. These were, it's a little bit of the, is it perlite that I had left over when I was making up some tubs. You can see the male spider. Yeah, I think I'm gonna maybe do a giveaway with him or sell or trade him or something. I don't know. So I really don't have a use for him. And as far as my snake ambassadors go, everybody loves the jungle carpet python, so I've been basically, she's downstairs in the living room area, so. Then I have another male ball python down there, Sam. He's about, I think 11 years old. So he's down there, then two bearded dragons have plenty of reptiles down there. And I can't see just, and I have the, another male that I've purchased. It's one of my first snakes, one of my first purchases. Who's a black pastel? He's a black pastel spider yellow belly. So I'm really not in need of a single gene spider. And I also have a single gene black Foxtail male that I'll probably find another home for, just because I have a male that contains both of those genes already. So, yeah, that's the update for that little DIY project. I like it. See my snakes looking at me like, what are you doing, man? But, yeah, I think they'll dig it. All right, guys, until next time, I'll catch you later. Peace.